Well, I always remember how they beat us. I always remember how we had the dadgum game won, how we had a four-point lead with less than 2 minutes to go, and we hadn't lost a game like that in years. They had the ball in 20. I mean, they had no way. And then in three plays, they go ahead of us. Yeah, I couldn't sleep quite a few white nights after that one. I don't know. It was probably a month or more before I got where I didn't wake up in the middle of the night thinking about that game. Yeah, that one hurt bad.
Every year our goals is national championship, but we first have to win the ACC championship. And then secondly on that list is a state championship. And to do that, we had to beat Miami and we have to beat Florida. And that's something that we haven't won in the past couple of years.
They got a great front seven. You know, they with Javon Kirsten, Johnny Rutledge, Mike Peterson. You know, guys are great linebackers. And, you know, our offensive line got to go out there and dominate.
I mean, it's definitely a hostile environment. I mean, both teams had a lot at stake. So, I mean, it's just one of those games where anything can happen. You never know what play is going to win the game. So everybody's 150% every play.
You know, you never can tell what Steve may do. You just have to be ready for anything. You know, at the end of the game, we want to be able to say that we beat Florida, you know. Florida want to be able to say that they beat us, but more so for bragging rights.
Don't rough the punter, though, man. Don't forget on punts now. Let's hold our bullets up when we get something going back. Backs, protect the ball. Offensive line, flat back on your short yardage now. Go line, good flat back. Knock them guys out of there. We run that sneak. Get some movement, offensive line. Get movement. So that quarterback can get that yardage needed. Men try to get sacks, 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 but no penalties. In other words, you don't want to get a rough in the penalty. You know, if he's got that ball in his hand and he's released it, I can hit him. But once the ball is gone, don't get us a penalty. Use good judgment on that. Make your man pay, man. 60 minutes, we need to pound for 60 minutes. The guy's trying to block you. You need to pound him for 60 minutes. You know, get it in your favor.
Yeah.
Okay, who's going to block a punt today? Who's going to? I watched see Ohio State today play. They were finally about to beat Michigan the first time in years. One of the guys went and blocked the punt. As much talent as they have. Well, let's go ahead and have our prayer, and then we'll just sit and wait until somebody tells us what to do about what time to leave. Okay? Dear Father, thank you for this great opportunity. Help us to have self-control. Help us to have self-control. Some of us lost it out there a while ago. We've got to have self-control. Help us to play our best. Give us great spirit. Help us to play our best, and we pray that nobody will get injured. Protect us from injury. Pray that you'll heal our injured boys. Give us wisdom as we make decisions. Give our coaches wisdom as they call plays and make decisions. And we just pray that we can glorify you. Oh Lord, again, help these young men to control have self-control and just play as hard as they can when the ball snaps, and then not afterwards. These things we ask in thy name. Amen.
Amen.
This rivalry didn't get any friendlier with a pregame brawl at midfield. The Seminoles' home turf was being invaded by unwelcome visitors. A record crowd of over 81,000 was worked into a frenzy from the get-go as the Seminoles kick off.
John Capel and Robert Gillespie to return. Here's the kickoff, and Janikowski sends it 7 yards deep.
Doug Johnson would lead the Gators on the field.
And a handoff to McCaslin, runs up the middle. He's mugged at the 20 for no gain.
After a short run, the try becomes their own worst enemy.
Goes right, fires to his right, it's intercepted.
Yes,
to the 10, 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown!
Woo!
Two flags to hold everything.
Defense held us in that first half. Penalties killed us all. Defense, if the defense did anything bad, it's penalties, which is lack of discipline.
However, they would stiffen and force the punt.
And freshman David Wasilewski will punt the football. Pooches it, trying to get it away from Reggie Durden. Makes the catch out of the 30. Comes outside, breaks the tackle, stiff arm. Still running to the near sideline. Gets the corner turn to the 30. To the 35 he goes, and he's knocked out of bounds.
With everybody expecting FSU to run, Marcus Allison whips one to Peter Warwick.
The pass toward Warwick on the left flats. Got it to the 40. Warwick to the 45, and he's whipped out of bounds. Far sideline, right at the 46.
But the Gator defense also shows they came to play and hold the Seminoles.
Right, he must have saw the flag.
Well, it's fourth down, low snap, dugout. Here is the kick, just got it away. And McGriff will angle over toward it, makes the catch. Oh, he fumbled the ball, picks it up on a bounce. Running laterally across the field at the 15-yard line. He's tackled by Bradley Jennings.
Steve Spurrier's fun and gun offense goes airborne. Two plays later, they hit Pater.
It is caught by the tight end. Second down, 9, moving left, offset on. Johnson to throw, has time. Looking to his right, now to his left. Goes downfield toward McGriff. He's got an easy touchdown. Tate Cody slipped down, touchdown Florida. First score of the game.
That touchdown.
FSU was offside, so a little shorter look, and the point after is good by Chandler.
On FSU's next series, they're again hurt by a penalty.
They don't get the snap away, and we lose 5 yards on delay.
On third down, Outson is sacked. Ball comes loose. Reggie McGrew recovers, and the Gators are within striking distance.
Moving left. Johnson, two-step drop, gets the pass away.
But the Seminole D loves a challenge. After two incompletions, Sean Key becomes the hero.
Here from the 19, third down 10. The snap. Johnson looking, looking. Under pressure. Johnson rushes to a right. Throws it toward the end. Take it off. Yes, yes. Yes. To the 10-yard line. Florida State to the 20. With a convoy to the 30-yard line.
Well, the main thing that we tried to do, we just tried to involve enough people in coverage. We felt like with the things that Florida was doing in their passing game, that they always just kind of outnumbered you, whether you were in zone or man. And so our thought was they get the ball off in such a hurry that your four-man rush has difficulty getting there. So we just took one of the linemen out and took a couple of backers out. We played with three down people and a linebacker and seven defensive backs that we could involve in the coverage. And you know, the thing that we did was not all that revolutionary by any means. A lot of people do that. But we just felt like we had to involve that many people in coverage to take away some of the things that Florida does in their passing game. And We were very, very fortunate in that we got the execution we needed and still held up for the run as well.
Bobby Bowden and Mark Rick turned to the ground game, and Travis Miner delivered.
35, 40, 45. He's to the 47-yard line. High formation. Alchin hands the ball off to Miner. Miner comes to the near side. 40, 35. Well, there he goes. Down the sideline, 20. Yeah, and he's knocked out of bounds.
The Seminole offense then sputters. Sebastian Janikowski is called on to get FSU on the scoreboard.
Here's the snap out of the shotgun. Oh, and Alchin on the quarterback draw. Alchin cuts it to the 15, 14 to the 13. This will be spotted at the 26, PT, a 36-yard effort. Sebastian Janikowski, the spot, the hole by Alchin, the kick shot, plenty of distance. It's right down.
After Janikowski rips one through the end zone, the defense knows they have to be the best defense on the field this day. Outson takes hold of the reins and leads the team downfield.
In space, and he's out of bounds with a first down. Gain of four, third down, or second down and six. Outson dropping under pressure. Outson's going to run. Outson runs to the 45, to the 47-yard line. And he will miss the first down marker. Here's the snap. And Outson wants to throw. Steps up out of the pocket. He'll run the football. He dives, and he's got the first down across the 50.
Well, I knew somewhere along the line Marcus was going to have to prove he could drop back and throw the ball. And I knew there was going to be some third and long situations where, you know, we were going to have to protect and throw the ball downfield. And I really felt like when he hit those couple square ends, one to Peter Warwick and one to Lavernius Coles, I think that made them feel like he was a legitimate guy that they had to defend the pass against. And then it really helped the quarterback draws become much more dangerous play for us.
After a sack, Bowden calls for the first trick play.
He wants to throw the pass. Throws it right back over across the field. Caught ball. Oh! Dropped the football. A little razzle-dazzle, the lateral, and the throw back to the quarterback, and Marcus Outson had a convoy in front of him. And if there's anybody...
But on third and 16, Outson finds Warren.
Outson steps over the pocket. Throws the pass down. It's caught. Here's down to the 35. Peter Warwick's got it at the 31.
And that shows me a lot about this young man there. Most times a quarterback who can run the football would have ran it in that situation. He knew he couldn't get enough yards. He waited, found Peter Warwick.
Two plays later, the Gators get a roughing the passer penalty just before the end of the first quarter.
Personal foul, roughing the passer.
Hey!
As the second quarter begins, the Seminoles can't punch it in and call again upon the Polish powder keg.
Here's the snap. Here comes the pressure. Outson, pump fake. Outson, did a run into traffic. He'll be long field goal attempt. Here's a good snap. The spot, the hold down, the kick airboard. Janikowski puts it right down Monroe Street.
Yes.
42-yard field goal. It could have gone 62.
Great.
And it's 7-6 with 13:37 to go in the second quarter.
The Gators pick up 16 on this pass from Johnson to Taylor.
Dropping Johnson, play action. Johnson, he gets the pass away. Caught over the middle at the 40 to the 42-yard line. Travis Taylor, little drag route. Deep pattern about 20.
The defense clamps down before Johnson hits Travis McGriff for another first down, all the way to the Tribe's 34. Mickey Andrews' defense has seen enough.
Gets the pass away at the last moment, and it's overthrown. Johnson in the shotgun. Here's the snap. Here comes pressure up the middle. Pass. Oh, it's nailed. Two Seminoles handed in their heels. Set. Five wide receivers. Inside pressure. Inside pressure. Johnson's going to be sacked at the 45 by Brian Allen. Brian Allen from Lake City, Florida. Sacks Johnson at the 45.
Deep in their own territory, Outson has a tough task at hand. And on third down, the Gators get to
it. Arm, flushed out of the mouth, fumbles the football to the goal line. It's recovered by the Gators. Touchdown, Florida. Sherrard Warren. Now wait just a minute. It's a safety and not a touchdown.
You know, that's one thing that you got to be careful of anytime.
The fumble is ruled a safety, thanks to the recovery by Ross Brennan. The Gators increase their lead to 9-6.
Don't give them a chance to sack you and make a big play like that.
I guess they're ruling a safety in the end zone.
After the kick by Janikowski, the Gators mount what would be their last drive of the game.
15-yard line, and with the football, this is the returner to the 35-yard line. Roberts, the fullback. Gators move to our right. Here's the snap. They want to hand it off, and the Seminole, Tommy Polly, close the gap in a hurry.
Seminoles continue to hurt themselves with penalties as UF continues to move.
Break down. This pass is caught in the flat, and Napis Kareem is dropped short of the first down marker of the 40.
Receiver short of the first down. That's a tough route to cover. A little quick out by the inside slot receiver. Good job by Troy Saunders.
Well, Travis McGriff says
personal foul. Hands to the face on the defense.
A couple of passes and then a run get Florida all the way down to the FSU 7.
Moving right, here's the snap. Has time, starts to break down, flushed out of the pocket. Doug Johnson wants to run, throws the pass downfield. It is caught at the 20. Here's the snap, reverse to Capel. Capel gets the corner turn to the 15, to the 10, to the 5.
But the defense says, no way. An uncharacteristic third down run. That's 0 for the Gators. They settle for 3.
Back and nowhere for McCaslin to go. So digging in. Here's the snap. Can't get to it. The kick is airborne. It is good just inside the right upright.
The Seminoles and Gators' bitter rivalry heads to the locker room with Florida on top by 6.
45. So maybe down just 6 at halftime.
We straight. We're going to put on a clinic in the second half. Now. You know we straight. That's what tools the agility. Let's do
it. Let's stop it up, make some plays. The defense over there working it behind them. We need to do the same thing. Stop on making plays. Everybody, man.
Nah, Lee, we come
too far. Right.
We've been working all
the
time for this shit, right?
Do
what we work for to get
out.
Do what we work for.
Stop
doing it,
man.
Do what we work for.
Every day,
ain't nobody getting no. Hey, ain't nobody getting no. Ain't nobody getting no break. Let's go out there and grind. Hey, people over there, same thing, man. Let's go out there and grind.
Hey, we got to turn it down. Hey,
Let's go, man. Come on.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, this here gonna tell what kind of character we got or what we're gonna pay this way for that or what? Hey. Time to bring it back, hey. Man.
Hey, hey, look, hey, man.
Hey, you doing what you're doing.
We don't talk to our people over there now. Y'all boys grinding. We gotta keep it up second hand now. Yeah, yeah, yeah. We know, hey, y'all get a job now, man. Let's go get out. Y'all come on, let's grind. Y'all pick it up.
Remember what Pride 5 said, baby.
Gotta
be some good housekeeping.
Good shot, man. Hey, we come on. We go grind. Y'all keep it up.
Hey, good shot, man. 645.
Listen up now. Ben, do you remember the second half of the Virginia game when Winkie got hurt? Came in and went out and played the best half we've ever played right here. The defense got on fire, gave them nothing. The offense, Marcus was about 6 out of 7. We protected our passer, we ran the ball, and we jumped all over them. Now we've played better in the second half every game, and we're going to have to play better this half. The defense is doing a pretty good job. Now, they got a kickoff to us, man. They got to kick off to us. The offensive line, you need to do it. I hadn't looked at the film, but it seems like they're just out rushing you and out hitting you. They're bull rushing you and whipping you. Now this is you got to check it this half. You got to check what we made out of this half. We got the front right there. We got the crowd. We got everything in our favor. But they're we're not protecting a passer. He ain't got time to cock his arm. Quarterback, you got to get back deeper. Get back off that line of scrimmage, yeah? And then if they'll rush deep, then you can step up and throw it. Don't rush shallow. Now, man, offensive line, I've got to get my man. First, I got to set. Then I have got to stop his charge. Where our quarterback can throw the darn ball. We're getting people open. We don't have time to throw the football. Defense, just play hard. Be sure to stop the run first. Captain's gone. Be sure. All right, let's stop now. Defense, be sure to stop the run first like you're doing. Defense, you need to make some plays. You've had interceptions in your hand, you drop them. Now this is the middle of the Virginia game. Man, we got to have everybody. We can't do it with just one group. Offense, you've got to play your role, man. We're playing right out on our backyard. Looks like you'd fight your guts out there, man. You have to get your nose bloody, get it bloody. Defense, you got to stop your penalties. You got to stop your penalties. Now, if you'll block the bullets, we get a punt return. Block the bullets, we get a punt return. Now, we're going to have a big play. We went out there before that game, did a lot. Some of you guys are sorry you're talking over there. You know, you need to back that up a little bit. You need to back it up. We need some, how much time we got? We need somebody's got to make big plays. A great player should make great plays. We got to have some great catches. Hey, they only down 6 points. Really, offense is only kick 2 field goals. We need some great running now. When we punt, I'll be sure to protect your punter. Okay, hold it now. Listen to it. The man, we got 30 more minutes. This is a team last year. It was the same boat. We were behind at the half. We went out there and got ahead of them. Had the game won with 2 minutes to go. Then they go 80 yards for a touchdown and beat us. Now we got 30 more minutes. No, we got 30 more minutes.
3 minutes.
Oh, okay. Everybody ready to go?
Yeah. Let's go, man. Let's go, man. Let's go, man. Let's do this now. Let's go.
Let's go, guys. Let's go.
Y'all stole, goddamn it, we'll win.
Never before in the rivalry of Bowden Seminoles versus Spurrier's Gators would one team dominate the other so handily. Florida State puts on a second half defensive clinic. Offense proves more than worthy as they dismantled their lizard opponents from Gainesville.
First down at the 47-yard line of Florida. Lavernius Coles skywalking, brings it down. 7. Here's the snap. Inside hand off Miner. Yes. Miner's got the first down to the 35 and the 32.
Euphoria fills Stoke Campbell Stadium as FSU takes the lead for the first time.
Point after touchdown could break a 12-all tie. Janikowski puts it through Seminoles lead. 13-12.
The defense is brutal.
Toss pitch goes to the tailback. McCaslin's mugged by Lamont Green and dropped short of the 15-yard line. Loss of two.
Well, a great job by Lamont Green there.
Florida manages to only get to their 29-yard line before being forced to punt.
McCaslin's mugged. He won't get anything. Stopped at the 28.
On the next Gator series, they get most of their second half yardage on this one play.
Caught at the Seminole 28-yard line. Travis, he ain't moving right. Taylor in motion. Here's the snap. Play action. Dropping is Johnson. Johnson flushed out of the pocket. Will throw on the run. It is caught.
Yeah.
Picked off
yeah.
at the 7.
I see
it
you, Mario
at the 7. Mario Edwards.
I see you, Mario Edwards.
No flag. Seminoles force another turnover. Edwards with a leaping, acrobatic catch at the 7-yard line.
Outson leads the tribe on a ball control, time-consuming drive. Gives the defense a chance to rejuvenate.
Is in there to block. Three on the huddle clock. Here's this trigger. The toss pitch to the left side. This is Niner hurdling for first down. From the Gator 49-yard line. Here's the snap. And outside of the shotgun, under pressure. Outson breaks by to the left side. Outson's going to run. He's to the 50. He's to the 45. Oh, he's out at the 42 of the Gators. He didn't get that far upfield, but by golly, he ran.
Taking some time off the clock. The Noles are unable to get any points.
It is leading Travis Miner a little too far.
Florida has the ball going into the fourth quarter. The mighty Seminole defense holds the hapless Gators to 3 and see ya.
The fourth quarter, wind advantage. Toss pitch Miner. Runs to his left. Hits the corner turn.
Travis Miner gets the call and appears to have 6. A penalty that no one can find brings it back. Next play brings the return of the Riverboat Gambler.
Toss pitch. Will run the reverse option. Warwick's going to ride up a repeater. He's got Dugan to the 15, to the 10, 5, 3, 2, 1. Touchdown, Florida State. Now, touchdown FSU. Are there any flags?
It's pandemonium in Tallahassee, and it's Florida State by 8.
It's good. 20-12.
Defense is again ferocious. Nowhere to throw, nowhere to run. Goodbye, fun and gun.
Smith, number 96, Larry, high formation. Handoff Johnson to the right time. McCaslin's bug by Bobby Rhodes. Stopped at the 25.
We set out for that game, as we do every game, is to stop the run. And we were having success against, you know, with a running game. And when we forced them into passing situations, that's when we went to our dime scheme. And we'd done something similar to that in some of the other games, but didn't think we'd done enough of it. And I think we ended up running it something like maybe 18 times in the game. And it was very beneficial for us.
It's a good snap. Return is on. Here's the kick. Got a good one this time. Backpedaling is Durden. Feels it on the run at the 40. Far sideline to the 45. And he's out of bounds to the 46-yard line. He's quick.
The Seminoles, with confidence and home field advantage, start taking control.
45-50. He's to the 45. He's got a first down. The Seminoles move right. Here's the snap. High formation. Play action. Outs against the pass away. Near side. Diving catch.
Oh, what a great play.
Dugan's at the 29. He held on to it. Great throw by Outson. No chance of the pick by Cromarty. And a 10-yard pickup on the throw by Marcus Outson.
I see you, Ron Dugas. What a play.
Travis Miner picks up some of his 127 yards on the night.
Travis, he seems to really play well in the big games. And I think in the bigger games, we lean on him more heavily. And he's always come through for us. And I still don't know if he's 100% healthy from the very beginning of the year. But he really showed up in a big way. And If he didn't have that one long run called back, he might have ran for, I guess he had run for over 150 yards that day.
But the second half, our offensive line just took charge. And you, again, they looked like a team. They looked like an OL that started the season inexperienced, but now had 12 games under the belt, and that's about what they showed.
Unfortunately, Jeff Cheney mishandles the exchange, and the Gators get a big break. Three straight incompletions show why FSU has the number one defense in the nation and on the field.
They're going to wave that one off. Jay Cody never gave up. He didn't look like Daryl Jackson. The shotgun snap, and he looks to the right, throws the pass far sideline, and again, Trailer could not. Here's the snap. Here comes pressure. Johnson looking, throwing it over the middle, incomplete pass.
We just kept trying to get better every day out there, and that's always a good sign. The thing that really concerned us at one point was the injuries. You know, we lost some key people. We lost Larry Smith right off the bat up in the kickoff classic, and then we lose Lamont, and then we lose some linemen, then we lose some DBs, and all of a sudden, you know, you're wondering, well, how are we going to get someone to continue to pick up the slack and perform at the level we got to perform at? But this group never backed down. You know, every day was a challenge for them to go out and get better. They did it as a group, and they've got something they can be proud of because they made it happen.
A bad punt sets the Seminoles up with excellent field position. From there, Marcus Outzen is the key man.
Maybe the 48. Again, Wasilewski trying to play game.
I think that if all they were worried about was his ability to run the football, then some of those quarterback draws wouldn't have been there. I think the fact of the matter was that on some third and long situations, they dropped into their normal two-deep zone type look, and they had to cover the square end, and Marcus did a good job of dropping the ball to the backs a couple times. They had to cover the field. So they're rushing the passer hard, and they're in coverage, and there's just no one assigned to the quarterback. And all of a sudden, Marcus goes slipping through there and makes some key first downs. It was a tough thing to defend that day.
Florida finally stops the drive. Luke Rosa Award finalist Sebastian Janikowski puts the nail in the coffin. Reggie Durden seals it as Doug Johnson throws his third interception of the game. Let the celebration begin.
First down, Florida State. Turnover.
It would be the second most dominating performance ever against a Steve Spurrier team. Mickey Andrews' defense would hold the Gators' high-powered offense to 204 total yards, just 61 in the second half. Nothing but awesome. The Gators would manage just two first downs in the second half and would go 0 for 13 on third down conversions for the entire game. Sheer domination. Doug Johnson was 13 of 36 for 187 yards and three interceptions. Defensive line, led by Larry Smith, Jerry Johnson, Jamal Reynolds, and Tony Bryant, would allow the Gators just 17 yards rushing. On offense, Marcus Outzen's dream had a happy ending. He was 13 of 22 for 167 yards and rushed for another 26. Peter Warwick led the receivers with 8 catches for 119 yards, and he threw for a touchdown. Travis Miner also was huge with 127 yards on 30 carries. Sebastian Janikowski was his usual self, hitting 3 of 3 field goals in a great team victory. The odds were against the Seminoles, but never underestimate the heart of a champion. It was as good a game and as great a half as the Seminoles have ever played. Bobby Bowden can sleep well tonight, and Seminole faithful have 364 days of peace. All is well in Seminole Nation. Florida State 23, Florida 12.
Look! Look! Go! player. I just want to thank everybody. Because we, I know the seniors, you know, we were undefeated in the stadium. So I'd like to thank everybody for y'all help.
I want to give honor to God, who's the head of all our lives. You know, with God, we everything, but without Him, we nothing. So, hey, everybody step up tonight, and good job, fellas.
Okay, now, I'm proud of you, man. That's as great. Now, don't say that. We're trying to get out of here. That's as great a football game as I've seen a group of guys play. Let's just talk about it. Now, the defense for 60 minutes, unbelievable. I mean, stop one of the best offenses in the country. Then our kicking game was excellent. Our offense had a little problems the first half. But boy, they went out the second half, that OL. Then what do you think about Rooster?
Everybody said Rooster couldn't do it, but he came and did it.
I'm going to have to sing one of my old songs to you. Know? Now, this is an old college song. Don't take it wrong. Ready?
Yeah.
They're laying eggs now, just like they used to, ever since that rooster came into our yard. Father, thank you, O Lord, for these young men. Thank you for their help. We pray that you'll heal anyone who was injured tonight, and we pray that you'll heal our other players that have been injured. Gosh, what a great victory that these young men gained. Boy, they increased their talents. They overachieved. They did everything that you could ask for the young men. So thank you, O Lord, for them. Thank you for this win. Thank you for giving the spirit. Thank you for our assistant coaches. Boy, what a great job they did of getting this football team ready. Thank you for our doctors and trainers and managers and our administration, all the people that made this possible. Andy Urbani, we can't thank him enough, and all that staff. No, Lord, we're gonna praise you with it, oh Father. At least I am. I'm gonna go out and preach your name. These things we pray in thy name. Amen.
It was a gratifying victory, no doubt. I mean, it's always good to beat the Gators, I mean, because it's so important to everybody. But I left the field with just more of a feeling of thankfulness and gratefulness, and just thought it was a great blessing to even be in that game, and to come out with a victory was outstanding.
Oh, the crowd played a big part. A crowd, they don't know how big. They did exactly what I wish they would do every ball game. Number one, they came out early. And they started cheering early, and our kids picked that up. They feed off of that. The other team feeds off of it too, but they feed off by what in the world we got into. Then they got louder and louder, and they stayed that way the whole ball game. They did our crowd did a fantastic job, and I guess I was as proud of that as any other factor of the game.
I think the best thing to say is that it was one of the greatest team efforts that we've ever been associated with, and certainly it was one that. You know, all of our coaches and our players had a big part to do in that victory.
Well, it's always a satisfying one, but the more they beat you, the more exciting the next win is. You know, they had beaten us two times in a row, and so when you beat somebody, you don't want three in a row. You know, so it stops the bleeding type, and it was big because everybody thought that when Winky went down, everybody kind of thought we'd win the game. It'd be close, but we'd probably win it. In Tallahassee with Winky. Well, when he went down, then everybody jumped on that other team. Nearly all the sports writers and the media here thought that definitely Florida would win it with us without Winky. That's why I was so glad to see Marcus do the job he did.
Inside pressure. Johnson's going to be hit at the 45 by Brian Allen. From the gate of 32, here Here's the snap. Outs and rolling left. The length of the pass. Oh, it's under. It's in front of the 20 by Burke. Burke sideline 15, 10. Burke to the 5. 3 down. Here's the snap. Play action. Dropping is Johnson. Johnson flush out of the pocket. Will throw on the run. It is caught.
Yeah!
Out of a simple timeout. Jeff Cheney now in there as the running back. Toss pitch. Will run the reverse option. The Warriors going to run up a repeater. He got Dooley to the 15. To the 10. 5, 3, 2, 1. Touchdown. Florida State. 28. High formation. Hand off Johnson to the right side. Yeah. Pass is bugged by Bobby Rose. Stuffed at the 25.
The ball. Put in perfect field goal.
Good snap. Here's the kick. It's airborne. Got plenty of distance. Play distance. It's good.